Since I issued that Law, the Land of Oz has been far more peaceful and quiet. But I learned that some of the witches and magicians were still practicing magic on the sly and using the six-leaved clovers to make their potions and charms. Therefore, I made another law forbidding anyone from plucking a six-leaved clover or from gathering other plants and herbs which the witches boil in their kettles to work magic with. That has almost put an end to wicked sorcery in our land, so you see the law was not a foolish one, but wise and just, and in any event, it is wrong to disobey a law. Ojo knew she was right, and felt greatly mortified to realize he had acted and spoken so ridiculously. But he raised his head and looked Ozma in the face, saying, "I am sorry I have acted wrongly and broken your law. I did it to save Unc Nunkie and thought I would not be found out. But I am guilty of this act, and whatever punishment you think I deserve, I will suffer willingly." Ozma smiled more brightly then and nodded graciously. "You are forgiven," she said, "for although you have committed a serious fault, you are now penitent and I think you have been punished enough. Soldier, release Ojo the Lucky and..." "I beg your pardon, I'm Ojo the Unlucky," said the boy. "At this moment you are lucky," said she. "Release him, soldier, and let him go free." The people were glad to hear Ozma's decree and murmured their approval. As the royal audience was now over, they began to leave the throne room, and soon there were none remaining except Ojo and his friends and Ozma and her favorites. The girl ruler now asked Ojo to sit down and tell her all his story, which he did, beginning at the time he had left home in the forest and ending with his arrival at the Emerald City and his arrest. Ozma listened attentively and was thoughtful for some moments after the boy had finished speaking. Then she said, "The crooked magician was wrong to make the Glass Cat and the Patchwork Girl, for it was against the law. And if he had not unlawfully kept the bottle of liquid of petrification standing on his shelf, the accident to his wife Margolotte and to Unc Nunkie could not have occurred. I can understand, however, that Ojo, who loves his uncle, will be unhappy unless he can save him. Also, I feel it is wrong to leave these two victims standing as marble statues when they ought to be alive. So I propose we allow Dr. Pipt to make the magic charm which will save them, and that we assist Ojo to find the things he is seeking. What do you think, Wizard?"
"That is perhaps the best thing to do," replied the Wizard. "But after the crooked magician has restored those poor people to life, you must take away his magic powers."
"I will," promised Ozma.
"Now tell me, please, what magic things must you find?" continued the Wizard, addressing Ojo.
"The three hairs from the Woozy's tail I have," said the boy. "That is, I have the Woozy, and the hairs are in his tail. The six-leaved clover I...
"You may take it and keep it," said Ozma.
"That will not be breaking the law, for it is already picked, and the crime of picking it is forgiven.